Today's video is sponsored by Private Internet Access. The Xbox Series X and PS5 have been out for a couple weeks now, and something that was asked of me a lot leading up to these launches was, what is Nintendo going to do about these next-gen systems? Or is Nintendo just going to even be okay with these next-gen systems coming out? What's going to happen to the Switch? Is the Switch good enough? Are we going to get a new Switch? So on and so forth. And my answer in reply to that was always, the Switch is going to be fine. It has its own specific category that it's holding. It's got its first-party titles. There's a lot going on for it where I really don't think next-gen systems are going to be an issue for it. But I would be lying if I didn't say that the time I've spent on the Xbox Series X and PS5 lately haven't made me a little more acutely aware of some of the problems currently existing on the Switch, primarily thanks to the fact that it is a system that came out at a very odd time. The timing of the Switch's original release back in 2017 has always been a little bit of an odd spot. When it comes to game generations, we've kind of been used to multiple systems coming out from all the major companies roughly around the same time, maybe give or take a year or two between them. But after the Wii U's initial problems and, well, total lack of sales, Nintendo went ahead and released a new system right after with the Nintendo Switch, which ended up being a great idea. In no way am I trying to imply that the Switch coming out when it did was a bad move. Obviously, it was the right call to make. But because of that timing, even though the Switch is only 3.5 years old, not really old enough to warrant a full replacement just quite yet, it does feel a bit odd seeing this as the current Nintendo system alongside what's starting to happen with the PS5 and Series X. Before I get into all the ways in which I think the Switch could start to use a little catching up, I do want to clarify once again, I think the system is going to do just fine, at least for the next year up against these consoles, because there is a lot going on in its favor, despite the gap in hardware specs that we're beginning to see. The Switch already had an amazing sales year so far this year, lots of big boosts, partially thanks to certain world events going on, so there's been a greater increase in interest for things like buying a gaming system. Something else that really helps it out is, it is a very affordable system. Yes, we do have cheaper versions of next-gen systems available, with the PS5 All Digital at $400, Xbox Series S at $300, but the mainline Switch still goes for that same price of $300, and if you want to go even cheaper, the Switch Lite is two. Especially if you're in a family situation, you could get a pair of Switch Lites to give to two different people, and that would still cost less than buying a brand new PS5 or Xbox Series X. And not only has the system itself sold well, but it's also had, honestly, a pretty good year for games. I know there's a little bit of an argument about as far as how many different big holiday releases the system can have, what's coming out soon for the system. There's a lot of anxiety, I think, for some people as far as seeing more first-party stuff come out for the system. But what has been releasing has still been great hits. Animal Crossing could not have come out at a better possible time and is one of the front runners for Game of the Year for a lot of people, for very good reasons. Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity just came out and is the top-selling Warriors game ever. That's compared to Dynasty Warriors, compared to the past Hyrule Warriors, compared to any other crossover game. In less than a week, that game has sold more than any other Warriors game ever, highlighting that clearly there is still a lot of active interest in picking up games for this system, and there are more titles on the way for next year. So yes, the Switch is gonna be fine and continue to do well, but it could certainly use some kind of revision very soon, and again, there have been a lot of rumors that we will be seeing some kind of new Switch model sometime next year. So let's just talk about some of the things where, especially now that I've had more time with the Series X and PS5, where cracks are starting to show in the Switch experience. Before moving on, I'd like to thank Private Internet Access for sponsoring this video. In today's online age, a VPN is basically a requirement for safe online browsing, making sure that it keeps your privacy intact and anything you do online remains safe and secure. VPNs have always been a useful way to protect yourself when connecting to public Wi-Fi, but even doing things from home, it can be very important to make sure you have a safe and secure connection, especially if you're ever entering personal details on a website or buying things online. Especially nowadays with more people than ever working from home, if you're ever handling any kind of sensitive or important information for work, that is not something you want to have end up on the internet. So it's very important to have a VPN like from Private Internet Access. PIA has been around since 2010 and is the leading no-log VPN service, winning PC Mag's Editor's Choice. It has unlimited access to 10,000 servers in 70 different countries with dedicated apps for all your major devices like a Windows PC, Mac, iPhone, Android, and more. Check out the link down below in the description to get 3 years plus 2 free months for just $79 with a 30-day money-back guarantee. That's basically just $2.08 a month. All right, switching. back to the Switch. When it comes to things that I think the Switch could really use an upgrade on, there's three main areas that really stand out to me right now. First off, account management. Not exactly a hardware level thing, but there are things about how Nintendo handles your ability to move around save data and have accounts on multiple Switches that could really use an overhaul. Save data, for instance. On the Xbox, everything is very simple. It auto-syncs, and I'm able to just continue my adventure whether I was playing at home on one Xbox or in the office on the other. On the Switch, however, I have to constantly make sure that for secondary Switches, I am downloading the most recent cloud save or uploading a new one if I'm finishing there and want to go back to my primary Switch. And for certain titles, like Pokemon games or Splatoon 2, you have to actually do a direct transfer because cloud saves are not supported for those games. What can be even more annoying, though, is dealing with which system is considered your primary console. Now, this is a little bit of a situational thing, and it is technically a problem on Xbox and PlayStation as well, but it presents unique problems for the Switch specifically, especially when it comes to family sharing. Let's say you have a Switch console that is your main one that you want to leave docked in for the whole family to use, and you have a Switch Lite that you like to have as your own personal portable option. Well, you actually need both of those to be your primary Switch for different reasons. For the Switch Lite, you need to have it be your primary, so you can play games when you're not connected to the internet, especially if they are digital titles, or if you have any DLC for them, it just won't let you play them otherwise. But for the home system that's docked, you need to have that be your primary system so you can share your games that the rest of the family wants to play on. One of the main reasons I really want to see this fixed is not only would it just be a great move for a lot of consumers that own the Nintendo Switch, but there's also, I think, a decent chance that the next Switch model we see could be a sort of opposite Switch Lite in that it is a permanently docked setup that cuts down costs by getting rid of the screen and, you know, having an actual built-in battery and that kind of thing, and focuses on just being a plug-in system to your TV that is more powerful than current model Switches. And if that's the case, a really interesting setup could be having that as your docked setup and a Switch Lite on the go to still have that Switch experience, but with more extreme examples in both. But if the account system is still the same way once we hit that, it's not going to be that effective of a setup. One of the things a lot of people requested and talked about when discussing a new Switch model is upping the resolution on the screen for portable mode, as well as increasing the resolution of dock mode all the way up to 4K. There's been all kinds of additional rumors and theories about maybe a new model making use of DLSS in order to at least achieve a 4K style image quality. But honestly, what I'm more concerned with is just making sure that all the games being released on the Switch are running nice and smoothly. Because while there are some games that are very well optimized and look great on the Switch, like for instance, say, Luigi's Mansion 3, there are other games where this sadly isn't really the case. Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity, for instance. Love the game, I've been spending a ton of time on it, it's been one of my favorite recent releases, but when it comes to performance on the Switch, it's not super great. The game makes use of dynamic resolution scaling, so it tries to maintain its frame rate by dropping the resolution at times, and even with that in place, the game does not maintain a smooth 30 frames per second. It's constantly dipping in frames, which can be very distracting in a high action game like that. Again, I'm loving the game and I'm able to push past that, but when we talk about things that we want to see in a new revised Switch model, I would love to see a spec bump. Not for the sake of getting higher resolutions or trying to achieve whole new video modes, but just making sure that a lot of the games that are pushing the current version of the Switch don't have that issue on a new version. One of the things I've really noticed the most, though, going from playing on the PS5 and Series X a lot to going back to my Switch, is loading times. The change of having a high-speed SSD inside of a modern-gen console, cutting down loading times significantly, even in large open-world games, is something that really stands out more so when you go back to a system that doesn't have that. It's not that the loading times on the Switch are unbearable, but once you're getting used to how fast games can load up on these faster methods of storage, it's something that really begins to stand out a lot more to you. But it's also a slightly more interesting problem on the Switch, because on an Xbox or a PlayStation, you're really just concerned with loading times from the internal storage. And even when we're looking at expansion options, like with the Xbox memory card or PlayStation allowing you to add additional NVMe storage, you're still looking at things that are very similar, offering similar or same load times. On the Switch, you're juggling internal storage, microSD storage, or loading directly from a game card. Now, with a new model Switch, obviously one of the things you could do is improve the kind of internal SSD that is in the system, offering higher transfer speeds, thus faster load times. Because while the Switch is not using an old school spinning hard drive, the flash storage it has is definitely slower than the speeds we're seeing on the PS5 and Xbox Series X. So upgrading that in a new model so we can cut down on load times would be awesome, especially in handheld mode where I feel like this issue is a little more noticeable. When games are loading up on your TV, I feel like you kind of have a reflex to, okay, I'll pull out my phone monitor, look at something. I'll do something else, talk to myself. When you're in handheld mode, you're holding that system and just waiting for it to go. Something I've definitely been acutely aware of while playing Hyrule Warriors. So having that cut down would be amazing. Now, of course, the internal storage on the Switch is not very large. And so when it comes to a next model version, it'd be great if we had something that was actually higher in size. You don't have to rely on alternative methods of loading up games. However, one way the Switch could increase those speeds with microSD is if they opened up support for UHS 2. The current model of the Switch only supports UHS, which is fast, but not nearly as fast as UHS 2 can be, which is almost 3 times the speed, which would definitely cut down those loading times when you're relying on a microSD card. Now, as for game cart loading, as things stand right now, the game cart loads slower than both internal and microSD storage, but not by a crazy margin. However, if we saw these other methods of storage increase in speed, something that would be a really welcome feature, I think, is the ability to full install game carts while still needing the game cart for a license check. This isn't something the system currently allows for, so if you're ever playing off of a game cart, it's always going to load from there. I would love that to be a supported option. Yes, it kind of gets rid of one of the benefits of a game card in that it doesn't save room on your storage, but if you're someone like me who doesn't mind buying a microSD card, but you still want to buy physical games for the sake of, you know, having physical copies, this is something that would really give me the best of both worlds, where I can have my physical collection, but still benefit from the faster loading times of having things directly installed. Whatever form it ends up taking, these are still really the main things that I really want to see addressed, because again, I love the Switch. None of this is any kind of move to be like, oh, the new systems are out and therefore the Switch is now outdated and bad. No, not at all. I think the Switch is a fantastic system still. I think it's a great pickup for a lot of people, and obviously it's still selling very well this holiday season. I just think that especially with these new next-gen options out there, now is a good time for Switch to really capitalize on refreshing its image, having something that really just helps it put just that extra little step above and show that it is still a very competitive option.